Admission. 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 Dear ladies and gentlemen, I bring good news. Admission into the diocese on the Niger School of Pharmacy Technician EENU Mission Hospital is on. The School of Pharmacy Technician, PHT, is an accredited tertiary institution that offers students a diploma degree to work in hospitals and pharmaceutical companies in order to promote safe and effective use of medicines at grassroots level. Graduates of Pharmacy Technician School EENU who wish to study pharmacy in the university can obtain direct entry into any university of their choice. The school has a well-equipped laboratory, comfortable hostel, and a healthy refectory. The requirements for admission are credit in English, mathematics, biology, chemistry and physics. In GCE, WAEC, NECO, NABTEB are not more than two sittings. The School of Pharmacy Technician, PHT, is located at EENU Mission Hospital, Agidi, Anambra State. For more information, call 0803-708-1512, 0813-868-2003, 0803-267-5322. Diocese on the Niger School of Pharmacy Technician. A tradition of excellence.
You are welcome to our online mathematics lecture. Today we are going to look at the UME 1979 mathematics question number 7. The question says, in base 10, the number 101101 base 2 equals A, 15, B, 14, C, 45, sorry, A, 15, B, 4, C, 45, D, 32, E, 90. This is a case of conversion of base number from other bases to base 10. But here now, they want us to convert 101101 base 2 to base 10. Before I go into this question, I want to really say one or two things concerning number bases. One thing you should know is that number bases, the number, normal counting number, number we use on our daily activities, daily calculations, has always been in base what? 10. What, you may not see any base, you may not see the number written like this, let's say 20 base 10, no. You may not see any base here, but whenever you see such number, know that this number is in what? Base what? 10. Decimal system, base 10, decimal, base 10. But in computers normally make use of what? Base 1. Sorry, base what? 2. Binary system, base what? 2. That is, number in base 2 are usually 10, 10, 10. This is what you normally use in computer. Let's continue. Another thing I want us to know is that in a particular number to a particular base, the highest digit you see in a particular number is always less than one to the what? To its base. See what I mean? Here now we have base 2. This is this number 101101 is in base 2. Look at the number. The highest digit in this number is what? 1. And it's 1 less than the what? The base. So you cannot find a situation whereby you have 2 here. 2 here. 2 here. Something like this, base 2. This does not exist, because this 2 here is the same thing with what? with the base, or you have something like this, it cannot exist, because 3 is greater than what? 2. So the highest digit in a number is at least, it should be at least less than, it mustn't be 1 less than. Okay, yes, yeah, the higher digit, it must not be 1 less than, no, but the point is this, it should be at least 1 less than the what? Base. For example, you can have, let's bring this up to base 4. You can have 201101 base 4. Yes, the highest digit here is 2. But the point is that it's less than what? It's less than the base, which is 4. It mustn't be, it mustn't be 3 for this to hold. That's what I mean. So the highest digit at least should be less than 1, less than the tolerable, the limit that can be tolerated is that it should be 1 less than the what? The base. It can be more than 1 or more than 2 less than the base, but at least it should be 1 less than the base. It should not be equal to the base or above the what? Base. That's my point. The highest digit in a number should not be equal to the base or greater than the what? The base. But at least it should be 1 less than the base or more than less than the base. But the point is that it should be less than the what? The base. So let's continue. Having cleared this, let me go into another thing. Another thing I want us to know is that, let's use a number in base 10. A number in what? Base 10, decimal number. That's the point I want to make. The number in base 10 normally makes use of the what? The place value. There's also what we call the place value. The place value has to do with the position, the actual position of a digit in a number. We call it place value, the actual position of a digit in a number. Let me look at this number. Let's take a look at this number. We have 2580. There are 4 digits in this number. The place value of each of these digits defines the actual position, the actual value of the position of the number in the words of the digit in number. The place value of the digit in each of these digits in this number explains or defines the actual value of the position of the digit in this number. Now, if you want to know the place value of each of these numbers, the first thing, each of these digits, the first thing to do is this: you position the what? Digits. You position the what? Digits. You assign the what? Position. Starting from the left, the positioning increases from the left. So from the right to the left, it increases from the right to the what? Left. If the number is a whole number, you start positioning from what? 0. What it means is that here now you assign a position here, 0 to this is 0. Assign position 1 to this 8. Assign position 2 to this 5. Assign position what? 3 to this 2. That is if it's a whole number. But if it's not a whole number, let's assume we have 2580.45. Let's have a number like this. What you do is, on assigning the position, any number, this is a decimal point. The numbers to the left of the decimal point is the what? The whole number. The whole number part of the number. While the part to the right of the decimal point is what? The fraction. Now, we have discussed on how to assign the position for a whole number. It still holds here. Here we have what? 0. Here we have what? 1. Here we have what? 2. Here we have what? 3. But on coming to this side now, What will happen is, once you cross this decimal point, you start assigning, you know, from here to here is infinity, from this 4-5 goes to infinity. You start assigning the number to the immediate number to the left, to the right of the decimal point. So you start from minus what? Minus one. You start from what? Minus one. The next one should be what? Minus what? Two. So this is, we have assigned position. And even there are other numbers here, it will continue minus three, minus four, minus five, and so on and so forth. So here now, we have assigned the position of this digit. So if you want to know the actual value of that word position, what you do is this: you start multiplying each of these digits by the number, the base of the number. Multiply each of these digits. If you multiply this digit, you multiply it by the base of that number. Raise to power the position of that word digit, already assigned position of the word digit. So here now we have two here. Two is the first word digit. So we now have two. The actual place value of this two is what? Two times the base of this number. Remember, it's in base 10. You multiply it by what? Base what? 10. Raise to the power the position of the digit, which is what? 3. So the actual place value of this number, first digit, is what? 2 times 10 to the power what? 3. So 10 to the power 3 is what? 10 times 10 times 10, which is what?
1,000.
1,000 times 2 gives what? 2,000. So the actual place value of this digit, 2, is what? 2,000. If you go to 5, digit 5, 5 times 10 to the power, remember the base, 10 to the power what? Position of that 5, which is what? 2. And this will give us what? 10 to the power 2 is 10 times 10, which is what? 100 times 5 will give us what? 100 times 5 will give us what? 500. So the place value of this digit 5 is what? 500. Is what? 500. Now, let's continue. We have 8. 8 times, remember the base is 10. Base power what? 1, the position, which is now 1. 10 to the power 1 is what? 10 times 8, which is what? 8. Now, here now, we have 0. 0 times the base is 10. 10 to the power what? 0. 10 to the power, any number raised to the power 0 is what? 1. So here is 1. 1 times 0 is equal to what? 0. So the place value of the 0 here now is still what? 0. Let's move over to the what? Decimal part. We have 4 here. 4 times the base is 10. 10 is power minus this is minus 1. Give us what? 10 is power minus 1 is 1 over 10. 1 over 10 times 4 give us what? 4 over what? 10. If you divide 4, then you get 0.4. Here now, this give us what? Let's leave it like that, because I want to explain something. Here we have 5 times 10 to the power what? 10. The base is 10. Raise power minus 2. This give us what? 5. This is 10 to the power minus 2 is 1 over 100, which is what? 5 over what? 100. This is the place values of this thing. So if you now break it down, you have this is what? 2 times what? 1,000. 1,000. So you cannot say that this is in thousands. Thousands. That's why you hear this. They tell you thousand. So this is what? Thousand. Thousand. This is what? 5 times, remember, 5 times 100. 5 times what? 100. This is what? 100. 1,000. 100. This is in 10. This is what? 10. This is now what? 8 times 10, which is what? This is 10. So we have 1,000, 100, 10. This is, has no decimal place. Place value is 0. Let's go over to here. This is 1, 10. So it's now what? Tenths. This is tenths. Tenths, not 10 now, because it has gone. Is now a fraction. Tenths. That's why we have. So this is now 4 tenths. 4 tenths. Because 4 over 4 times 1 over 4 times 1 over 10 is tenths. 4 times 10 is what? 4 tenths. This is 2,000. This is 500. This is 500. So 5 times 100 place value. 500. This is 2. 2 times 1,000 place value, which was 2,000. 2,000. Here now is what? 8 times 10. 80 times 10 is what? 8 tenths. 8 10. 8 10. This is 1, 4 times 1 over 10. 1 over 10 is 1 tenth. So 4 times 1 over 10 is? 4 times 1 over 10 is what? 4 tenths. This is hundredths. 100 is 100 is 100, but when we have 1 over 100, it becomes what? Hundredths. So this is now 500. 5 over 100 is 500. So having this place value in mind, I want to solve this question. Now, let's take a look at the question again. They say we should convert 101101 in base what? 2 to what? Base what? 10. So how do you go about it now? Remember what I told you. When it comes to this, if you now want to convert this now to base 10, we have to apply the same place value system we applied, I used to explain. And I forgot to tell you something. If you add up all those numbers I listed before, it will still give you back to that, back that initial number. Okay, I will use this one to explain it. Let's go. Now, here now, we apply that rule of place value for us to convert this to what? 10. So this is a whole number. So there's no decimal here. So remember the first thing to do is to do what? Assign this, they are having the digit in this number. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 what? Digits. And it's in base 2. And it's a whole number. So let's just assign position to this digit, that we call this number. And for us to assign this position, remember, I'm assigning the position, we'll start from the words, right to the left, in ascending order. So, because it's a whole number, we'll start from 0. Had it been this fraction here, this one will start from minus 1. But this is a whole number. So, we'll start assigning from what? 0. So now, position of this one in this number, this face, this one now, from right to left, is what? 0. Position of this number here is what? 0. Is what? 0. Sorry, let me get a marker. Position of this number here is what? 0. We have assigned 0 to this one. Position of this 0 here is what? 1. Position of this 1 here is what? 2. Position of this 1 here is what? 2. Three. Position of this 0 here is what? 4. Position of this 1 here is what? 5. So, in ascending order from right to left, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We have positioned them. We have assigned position to these digits. Remember, the first thing to do is to start multiplying the digits by the base. If you pick each digit, you multiply it by the base, raise to power the assigned position for that digit. So let's pick one. Here we now have what? We now have what? Let's open brackets. We now have what? One times the base is what? Two. Let's call the equation, which is what? Five. Plus here is zero. Zero. And the position is what? The base is what? Still two. Let's call our what? The position, which is four. Plus one times the base is still two. Let's call the position, which is what? Three. Plus bracket open. Here is what? One times the base, which is two. Position is what? Two. Plus bracket open again, zero times base is what? Two. Position is what? One. Plus bracket open again, last digit one times base is what? Two. The position is what? Zero. So let us solve this now. I will subtract so I don't waste time. Remember here now, what we now have here is what? 1 times 2. 2 raised to the power 5 is 2 times 2 into 5. 2 times 2 give you what? 2 times 2 give you what? 4. 4 times 2 give you what? 8. 8 times 2 give you what? 16. 16 times 2 give you what? 32. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it's 32. 32 times 1 is what? 32. So we bring down 32. Plus 2 raised to the power 4 is what? 2 times 2, 4. 4 times 2, 8. 8 times 2, 16. 16 times 0 will give you what? 0. So we bring down what? 0. Here, 2 raised to the power 3. 2 times 2, 2. 2 times 2, 4. Times 2, 8. 8 times 1 will still give you what? 8. We come here. 2 raised to the power 4 is 2 times 2, which is what? 4. 4 times 1 is what? 4. Here now, 2 raised to the power 1, any number raised to the power 1 is that number. So 2 raised to the power 1 is 2 times 0. Everything is now 0. So we add what? 0. Here now, 2 raised to the power 0, any number raised to the power 0 is what? Is what? 1. So 1 times 1 is what? 1. Yeah, plus 1. So if you add up these numbers, we have 32 plus 0, which is 32, plus 8, which is 40, plus 4, which is 44, plus 1, which is what? 45. This number is now in base what? 10. 45 to base 10. So converting this in base 2 to base 10 will give you what? 45 to what? Base 10. So this holds as you have, this holds for every number you are converting from is base. Even if it's base 1, base 2, base 3, base 4, base 5. Once you are converting it from that base to what? Base 10. This thing holds. You make use of the what? Place value system. Place value system. You make use of what? Place value system. So this is 45 base 10. Even if you don't write base 10, once you write 45, it means that it's in what? Base what? 10. Now there's something that I want to explain. That now I wanted to explain with the number, but because I had already explained this, I could not do it. Let me explain it with this 45. We are done with this question. The answer is what? The answer is what? C. The answer is what? C. Remember in JAM. UTME, you try to be as fast as possible. I took time because this is more of teaching you, trying to explain how to solve it. But in examination condition, you need to be fast. Break unnecessary words, steps that can help you be fast enough. Because it's not a theory question whereby it's not an essay whereby you show all your workings. Here now, try to cut short long steps. But as you're cutting short long steps, don't make mistake. Be fast and what? Accurate. Now, the answer is what? Option what? C, which is what? 45. Now, let me explain what I wanted to explain with this with this number, let me use 45 now. Now, if we have 45 now, 45 is invested, we already know. Now, take a look at this now. If you want to, let's position these numbers. We have, or let me add extra digits, like 4, 5, 6. Uh-huh. There are 3 digits here. You assign position to you, starting from, remember it's a whole number. You assign digits from the right to the left in ascending order. You assign position, sorry. Here we have what? 0. Here we have what? 1. Here we have what? 2. So the actual place value of this 4 here is what? We have 4 times. 4 times what? 4 times the base is 10. 10 is for what position, which is what? 2. And this will give us what? Okay, let me bring out everything. 5, this is 5. 5 times the base is 10, raised over the position, which is 1. We have 6. 6 times the base, which is 10, raised over the position, which is what? 0. This will give you what? 10 raised over 2 is 10. 10 times 10, which is what? 100 times 4. We have what? 400. This will give 10 raised over 1 is 10. 10 times 5 is what? 50. This will give you what? 50. 10 raised to 0 is 1, because any number raised to 0 is 1. 1 times 6 is what? 6. Now let's add up these numbers. If you add up this number, you still get back this 4, 5, 6. So let's see. 400, okay, 0 plus 0 is 0 plus 6 is what? 6. 0 plus 5 is what? 5. Bring down what? 4. 400 plus 50 is 450. Plus 6, 4, 5, 6. We are now back. Taking us back to this number. This is the power. This is the magic of what? Place value system. So the actual value of this 4 in this 4, 5, 6 is what? 400. Which is what? 400. Because this is in 100. This is 10. This is in what? This is in what? Units. Because it's what? 1. Is what? Unit, because it's what? 1. So now, as you can see now, we have 10 hundred, tens, and what? Units. So now here is 400. 400, that's why you call it 400. 400. This is 10. 5 times 10, 50. 50, 5, 10. This is unit, which is 6. 6, this is unit 1, that is 1, 3, 6, this is 6. If you add it up, it will give you what? 4, 5, 6. So the place value of this 4 here is 400. Of this 5, the value of 5 here is 550. That of 6 stays what? 6. That's why if you add it up, it will give you what? 4, 5, 6. Thank you very much for your attention. You can read more on place value system. I just use this question to explain one or two things so that you can understand why we change this to the base 10 using this the formula the taking the steps I took. It's because of what? The place value. Use place value system to convert the data number from its base to base what 10. You apply the what? Place value system. Thank you very much for your attention. See you next time. Thank you for watching our online lectures. For lecture updates, please subscribe to our YouTube channel. The name is Susan Limited. Just click on the red button and click on the bell by the side so that you'll be among the first people to receive notification whenever we upload a new video. Please like and follow us on Facebook. The name is Susan Limited. If you have any question, please connect with us on WhatsApp. These are our WhatsApp numbers. Please visit our website. The address is susanlimited.com. You have a lot to learn. Please share this video, like and comment. Thank you for your support. God bless you.